हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ दीपक एंड वेलकम टू माय चैनल दीपक बायोलॉजी क्लासेस। तो स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट फोर किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन। सो बिफोर मूविंग टू दैट, लेट मी रिमाइंड यू अबाउट माय लास्ट लेक्चर। तो इन द लास्ट लेक्चर व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द थ्री किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन व्हिच वाज गिवन बाय हेकेल। सो इन द थ्री किंगडम क्लासिफिकेशन, दिस हेकेल ही हैज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड वन मोर किंगडम, दैट इज प्रोटेस्टा। सो what was the basis or what were the criteria? So on the basis of lack of tissue differentiation, okay, that was the criteria. So means those organisms which lack the capability of tissue differentiation has been kept in the group protista. So it include bacteria, okay, algae, because they don't have the capability to differentiate their tissue, okay. So that criteria he has used and then he introduced the term protista. So today we are going to talk about four kingdom classification. So this four kingdom classification, it is given by Copeland, okay. In 1956, okay. So now the question comes, like why, like he has given the four kingdom classification, because in the three kingdom classification there was no group for the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Means they have kept the prokaryotes and eukaryotes in the same group, that is in the protista. So as the time passes, then there is a discovery of electron microscope, okay, electron microscope. So with the help of this electron microscope, we can see a very naked molecules, or we can say very like those microorganisms which we can't see with our naked eye. So with the help of this electron microscope, we can see the microorganisms like the bacteria, viruses and the mycelium of fungi, like that, okay. So with the discovery of electron microscope, he has divided, or we can say he had included one more group. And what is that group or kingdom? That kingdom is called Monera, okay. So why he has introduced this kingdom Monera? Because with the help of electron microscope, he can differentiate between the prokaryotes and eukaryotes, okay. So what were the criteria? So the criteria was on the basis of nuclear structure, okay. So he has used the nuclear structure as a criteria, and then he introduced one more kingdom, that is Monera, okay. So with the help of this electron microscope, he has seen that there are some microorganisms which don't have the true cell wall, or we can say that they don't have a nucleus which is enclosed by, like nucleus in which the genetic material is enclosed by a proper membrane, okay. So in the group Monera, he has kept all those organisms which is having the false nucleus, or we can say the incipient nucleus. Means they are having the genetic material, but that genetic material is not enclosed by any membrane. So he kept all those organisms, all the primitive prokaryote means primitive nucleus, okay. If we differentiate this prokaryote, so it means pro means primitive, and karyote means nucleus, okay. So he has kept all those prokaryote which is having the primitive nucleus, means which is having the nucleus, which is having the genetic material like RNA or DNA, but it is not enclosed by any membrane. So he has kept all those prokaryotes organism into the kingdom Monera. So after that, so it has been divided now. First one is Monera, then protista, then plantae, and the last one is animalia. Like in the three kingdom system, what we studied, Haeckel has introduced that protista kingdom, then plantae, and then animalia. So it was three kingdom classification. But in order to overcome the drawbacks of the three kingdom classification, Copeland had introduced one more kingdom, which is called Monera. Okay, this Monera. So what are the criteria? He classified all the organisms he kept all the organisms on the basis of nuclear structure. Okay, on the basis of that, he has kept all the prokaryotic organisms into the group Monera, like the bacteria, or we can say it's like cyanobacteria. Okay, so now we will study about the specific properties, or we can say specific characteristic of the organisms, and then we will place all those organisms into the different kingdom. Okay. So first one is Monera. Okay, so in that organism, with incipient or nucleus, or we can say false nucleus. For example, bacteria or blue green alga. That is cyanobacteria. Okay, now we'll see in the kingdom Protista. So, organism with two nucleus. And having characteristic and characteristic of both plants and animals. Example, red brown algae protozoans. And next, plantae. So in plantae, what groups will include? So it will include all those groups having cell wall, autotrophic, stored food is starch. Then this plantae include all like algae, multicellular algae, then bryophytes, टेरिडोफाइट्स, जिम्नोस्पर्म, एंजियोस्पर्म्स. नाउ वी टॉक अबाउट द एनिमेलिया. सो इन एनिमेलिया नो सेल वॉल, हिड्रोट्रॉफिक, स्टोर्ड फूड इज ग्लाइकोजन. इट इंक्लूड्स पॉलीफेरा, क्नाइडेरिया, आर्थ्रोपोड्स, मोलुस्कास. ओके, सो दीज आर द फोर किंगडम विच इज गिवन बाई कोपलैंड, दैट इज बोनेरा, प्रोटिस्टा, प्लांटी एंड एनिमेलिया. सो वॉट ही डिड, ही हैज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड ऑल दोज ऑर्गेनिज्म विच इज हैविंग द इंसिपिएंट न्यूक्लियस, मीन्स देयर जेनेटिक मटेरियल इज नॉट इन्क्लोज्ड बाई एनी न्यूक्लियर मेम्ब्रेन. ओके, सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल बैक्टीरिया और सम ब्लू ग्रीन एल्गा, मीन्स सम साइनोबैक्टीरिया. नाउ वील टॉक अबाउट द प्रोटिस्टा. सो इन प्रोटिस्टा he has kept all those organisms which is having the two nucleus, means their genetic material is enclosed by nuclear membrane. Okay, then it include like some red and brown, red brown algae, some protozoa. Okay, then in the kingdom plantae he has introduced or he has kept all the plants which is having the cell wall, which is having autotrophic mode of nutrition. Then they can store food in the form of starch with the help of a mechanism called photosynthesis. So it includes some multicellular algae, or we can say some unicellular algae which have the capacity to do photosynthesis, like the Chlamydomonas. Then he has introduced bryophytes, pteridophytes, gymnosperms, angiosperms also in the group plantae. After that, in Animalia, he has kept all those organisms which don't have cell wall. Instead of cell wall, they are having the plasma membrane. Then their mode of nutrition is heterotrophic, and they stored food in the form of glycogen. And then it includes various kingdom like the porifera, cnidaria, arthropods, molluscas, echinodermatas, etc. So Copeland has used the criteria of nuclear structure, and on the basis of that he has introduced the term monera, and then in that monera he has kept the organism with incipient nucleus. So now we'll discuss about the drawbacks. So drawbacks, what are the drawbacks? Or objections. Okay, so what is that? Fungi. Means in the four kingdom classification which is given by Copeland, he didn't put any fixed position for fungi, because fungi, they are like fungi, they show the character of both the animal also, like plant character also, plant character along with that animal character. Means it is having cell wall, and it is, the mode of nutrition is heterotrophic. Means it releases some chemicals, or we can say some digestive enzymes, which broke the complex molecules into the smaller molecules, and then these fungi, they absorb. Okay, so its mode of nutrition is absorptive nutrition, or we can say it is heterotrophic, means it is dependent on other. Okay, so the position of this fungi is even not fixed in the four kingdom classification given by Copeland. So this is a major drawback. Because of that, this system has not been accepted and has been failed. Okay, so here this video has been finished. So we have discussed about the four kingdom classification. So in the coming videos, now in the next lecture, I am going to discuss about the five kingdom classification, which is the most accepted classification, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So five kingdom classification is the most accepted one. So in my next lecture, I am going to discuss about the five kingdom classification system. So if you are new to my channel, please subscribe my channel. If you like the video, then share it. Thank you.